Hello friends, welcome to TechGrowth. So in this session we will see introduction to Docker container in COVID-19 style. Okay, so be ready to understand what all about it is. So as you aware of coronavirus, which is COVID-19, right, which is spreading all over the world day by day, and it is just uncontrollable as of now. So to have that in mind, I am just introducing to container technologies here, right? So you can see we have three blocks. One is this one, and second is this, and three this, right? So first of all, we have, if you are or I don't want to be you like that, so if a corona patient or any person who thinks that he is a patient and he is having symptoms or anything, so he have a clinic in his nearby, right, in their nearby. So clinic is just like a server or physical hardware or bare metal, right, in our IT technology, IT terminology, right? So if you will go to a clinic, right, there will be infrastructure. So it might be a small room or something like that, right, which has already built. There the doctor might have a machines and testing kits, right, that can be that will be certified from any government organization, right? That should be, because there may be some fake clinics. So on top of that, there will be three type of patients, right? One is low, you can say, which is having which has just assumptions that he might be affected with coronavirus. So he just he or she just came to clinic to have his or her test, right, if he is positive or negative. So it is those kind of patients. So obviously he will need a machine or testing kit at least, right, to have that test. So second is medium. Okay, mediums means he is showing symptoms, right, he got test, but he is negative, right, not positive, he is negative, and doctor will advise him to stay 14 days in quarantine at their home as well, they can, right. Third is high is the critical ones, which patients are positive, right, and they have to be in quarantine within under supervision of doctors or those, right, inside an hospital or somewhere other location, some any other facilities, right? So you can see the picture above I have shown. This is just a room clinic, right, where he is having doctor reception, that is not saying here. He is only having single bed, right? In this clinic, doctor have to check or test every patient, either they will be low, medium or high criticality, right, if they are showing symptoms or positive or negative, right, he has to take care of all those within this single room, right. So what is the issues here, right? So we cannot scale it, like if he got a lot of patients, like more than 10 or above, right? So he cannot scale it, their clinic, right? Second, he cannot move it, right? It is not portable, it is just fixed, so we cannot move it to somewhere else, right? Then it is low size, so it cannot accommodate more patients, right? Capacity issue, right? So this was about first terminology, which is we taken as clinic or for bare metal or physical hardware. Second is the example of hospital, right? We have same infrastructure for hospital, right? We have that building, right? 2 or 3 floor or 5 floor maybe. So we would have there all the testing kits and machines there, right, to testing all those patients. But here what we have extra one, we have management who will take care of all the needs, right, all the patients and all the resources. Okay, but difference will be that we will have different floors, right, or different wards, you can say. For low condition patients, we have different floor. For medium, we have just like say, for low patients, we have first floor, right? On the ground floor, we have just all testing kits and stores and all those things. On first floor, we have low symptoms patients. So second floor, we can have for medium condition patients, and third or maybe fourth floor will be for high one, right? So what will be the task of management team? Okay, they will provide everything, that testing kits and all the needs to every floor, right? Cleaning and all those things. You can see here, I have shown one picture of a single apartment that you can consider for high condition, right? Because we have everything there, right? One bed is there, every machines is there, and even we have nurses or doctors are there, right? So they will have testing kits for testing and take care of that patient, right, in all the wards. So we can take this single block as a separate wards, right? So in IT terminology, let me just compare it, right? So separate wards will be just like virtual machines, where we'll have our machines on every virtual machine and other things as well, right? So I'll show you the terminology architecture in next slide as well. So just to understand, hope you will understand, right? In hospital, same, we cannot scale it more, but for every wards, we need extra machines, extra testing kits and doctors and all the facilities, right? So this will also be a little difficult to manage, right? Next is a container, or you can say quarantine room, that is separate. You can see on the right hand side top, on the top, that we have multiple box type containers where we can set up a different facility room, right, for every patient. You can see example here, right? For a single patient, we can have a small single room with all the facilities. Okay, so here as well, we have different kind of infrastructure, but yes, we would have, right? We have infrastructure, right? We have testing kits available, right? And we have management who will provide these, you can see, you just take it as these as a store, right? And management will provide those testing kits to every container or quarantine room, right? If they will have, there are patients in any room, okay, they will require some things they are quarantined in hospital, or those rooms that they will need food and other things, as other facilities they might need, or treatments or those kind of things. So who will manage those? This management will manage those things, right, for us. So the management will take care of all the proper utilization of testing kits, whether these containers would require it or not, or any patient from this container will go and he is safe and he got recovered, so he can go, right? So if he'll go, then the management can took all those facilities provided to them and can provide that to another one, right? So the kind of resource management task will be for a management, right? So this is just like a quarantine room. You will be quarantined in a separate room, or just like this container, right? So these are three types of scenarios, right, for any patient or who thinks they are patient. But that was just for understanding purpose, right? I just to make you understand, but to we do not want that kind of situation for everyone. So it's better to follow these preventions, right? I have mentioned in down corner in the right hand side. So to prevent this coronavirus to be spreading from everywhere, right? We should wash our hands with soap at least 20 seconds, right? We should not touch our eyes or mouth or nose, because that enters from those places only. We should disinfect objects and all the surfaces we touch usually within our house or everywhere we touch those. We should wear a mask when we go outside of our room or our house to take some required things only, right? We should avoid close contacts with people, right? And the best way and the first thing, that stay home, right? Stay at your home only. Don't go anywhere. Avoid traveling to anywhere, either it's within city, within state, within country, or outside of country. So you should avoid traveling. And the last point, avoid contact with sick people, right, who are already affected or infected, right? So we should not avoid to be in contact with those kind of persons. So I hope you would understand all these things, and be safe, stay at home, right? So let's move our IT terminology now. So how it resembles that. So let's move to next slide, right? Yeah. So now you can see by this I will show you a difference between bare metal, virtual machine, and container. So as I showed you in my last slide for cleaning, right, that resembles with bare metal or physical server, where we have hardware, server hardware, right? We have a host operating system that will be used by that hardware, right? On top of that, we have different applications, right? App 1, App 2, and App 3, which have their own different libraries or dependencies, right, which they require to run. So everything for those application or all those applications will be hosted on the same hardware or same OS, right? That is the case of physical or bare metal server. Next is virtual servers or virtual machines, right? For those as well, we would have hardware for any server. On top of that, we would have operating system, which we can call the host operating system. On top of that, like we were having in our last slide for hospitals, we have management, right? So we have hypervisor here, and on top of hypervisor, we have different applications running, but every application is having their OS, operating system, which we called guest OS, right? So every application is having his personal operating system. So he's running, it will be just like a different server, which we can call virtual server, right? You can see here the whole application with operating system is can called virtual server. So we have these three different virtual servers, which are itself a server, a separate server, right? So what will be the task of hypervisor to manage to virtualize our host OS? To virtualize our hardware, right? And on top of that, we can install different OS. Like for app 1, let me install Linux as operating system. On app 2, we can install Windows, or in for app 3, we can install other kind of Windows, Ubuntu or Mac OS or like that, right? So we can have different operating systems on top of hypervisor. So hypervisor, we have two types of hypervisor, right? Hypervisor type 1 and type 2. So type 1 is native hyper, called also native hypervisor, which means where that will be directly built on the hardware, not on host OS. So you can see in the down, I have mentioned to remember, right? That on top of hardware, we directly will have hypervisor, and top of hypervisor, we will have virtual machines or virtual servers, right? And second is hypervisor type 2, which is hosted, right? On top of host operating system, we will have that hypervisor installed, and top of that hypervisor, we will have different virtual machines. So in this diagram, we can see that we are using hypervisor type 2. Okay, so this is the scenario for virtual machine or virtual server. So next, let's come to containers. Okay. For container, what we have on top, we will have hardware, or we have physical server, right? On top of that, we will have host operating system, and on top of that, instead of hypervisor, we would have container runtime. Okay, and on top of that container runtime, we would have our applications and their dependent libraries or binaries. Okay, so what will happen for this container? We are not having different OS, right? Especially for this. So what container runtime is doing? Container runtime is virtualizing our operating system to these containers. So we can have, you can see we are having three containers here. So all the three containers will be running on single operating system. So that operating system, we usually use Linux only. And right now there are Windows containers on Windows operating system as well. So if we use Linux here, so on top of that Linux, we can create number of any number of containers for different applications. So like if we are running Nginx application in application 1, right, in one container, in second container we are using Redis, in third container we are using MongoDB or any other application, PHP, Node.js, whatever we want, we can install here. Right, so this is third type. This is container, which you can in COVID style you can say it is quarantine, right, in different container or separate room. So what we have container runtime, right? So container runtime is kept using for management of image management, image transportation, and image unpacking, and other uses as well, like gRPC and web APIs connectivity, right? And we have different type of container runtimes, like Docker Engine, CRIO, and we have Rocket, LXD, LXC, and RunC, right? So we have different type of container engine. And host OS, how this container runtime will virtualize our OS. So it uses mainly three things. One is C groups, second is user space and kernel space. User space and kernel space are together called namespaces. Okay, so where namespaces allow us to virtualize our system resources like file system or networking. So that will be used like that. And C groups provides a way to limit the amount of resources like CPU and memory that each container can use, right? So what will be a container then? So a container will be which will be run using the container runtime. And if we are using Docker engine as a container runtime, then this container will call as Docker container. Okay, I hope now you would understand difference between bare metal or physical server and virtual machine and container, right? So let's see, now we have let's see some definitions of container. So a container is a standard unit of software that package up code, okay, and all its dependencies so the application run quickly and reliably from one computing environment to another. So what it means, within a container we are packaging our code, okay, application code with all its dependent libraries, right? So it will run fast or quickly, and it will be reliable from one computing environment to another. Then what will be a container image? Container image will be is a lightweight standalone executable package of software which are bundled together that includes everything need to run an application. So what an image will contain, it will contain all the packages like or dependencies like code, runtime, system tools, system library, and all the settings. Okay, and that was the all the packages or tools including. But when it will be called container, when so the running instance of an image will become a container, and right, so when the image will be executable or executed or it will be running, then it will be known as container. So we have multiple benefits of a container, right? Like resource efficiency. As I told, container runtime manages all the utilization of resources using C groups to limit all those resources used by any containers. So, and also we are not installing any operating system like we did in usually doing virtual machines. So it will be without that OS. So, right? So it will take few resources than a virtual machine. For size, as we are not using or installing separate OS for container, so the container size will be in megabytes only. Whereas the virtual machines will have size in GBs. So because we have installed operating systems on that as well. Third is low startup overhead. As I mentioned in above point, we have container size in MBs only as compared to GBs for VMs. So it will containers will start very quickly, and those will be easy to use, and those are platform independent as well. So as they are packaged independently and small in size, so we can use them anywhere, or it is platform independent, we can those are portable to anywhere. So portability is also the main feature of containers, and we can run them anywhere, either on bare metal, on virtual machines, or in the public or private cloud. We can run anywhere those containers. As the build code is write once only, and we can use then it anywhere. So it will be like write once, read anywhere. And there are other features which are most important are just like isolation, right? Like in quarantine. So we can share same server, same resources, but in isolation, where we have OS virtualization or OS isolation. We can also scale it horizontal, right? So within a cluster, we can add multiple containers horizontally. So like that, we can use horizontal scaling feature of containers, and due to the isolation feature, those are secure as well, right? So you must be thinking about that horizontal scaling. What is horizontal scaling, and what are other like vertical scaling and scale out, scale in? You might heard or you will hear about those as well most of the places, right? So horizontal scaling is let me make you understand. Let first make you understand with vertical scaling or scale in, right? Those are the similar similar terminology. So scale in and vertical scaling. means we have a server, like we have our laptop, we have just 4 GB and 4 GB RAM, 500 GB storage, and just 2 cores. So what we can do, we can upgrade that to that, we will upgrade from 4 GB to 8 GB, right? We scale our laptop, then 8 GB to 16 GB, right? So what we did, we scale in or vertical scale our laptop from 4 GB to 16 GB. Same for storage, we can have 500 GB to 1 TB, and then 2 TB, 3 TB. So that will be for storage scaling. Third, we have cores, right? From two cores to 4 cores, 4 cores to 8 to 16 cores. So it means within the laptop, or you can say within the server, if we expand our resources like cores, CPU cores, memory, and storage, that will be known as vertical scaling or scale in terminology, right? In comparison of that, if we'll go with scale out, means out, you can think of scale out means outside of that computer or server, right? Means scale out that if we are using one more computer, laptop, or one more server, right, with the same configuration or different one. So let's say if we are having 4 GB and 500 GB laptop, right? If we'll connect with two more with the same configuration, then we, or three more, right? So we will have four laptops with 4 GB and 500. So it will total 16 GB RAM and 2 TB storage space. So if all those four laptops will work together to storage, for storage and processing for any application, that will be called as scale out or horizontal scaling. Same in the servers, if we have multiples, we can add multiple servers, right, to expand the resources, that will be known as horizontal scaling or scale out. So those are the main features, like isolation, right, portability, we can run anywhere, and horizontal scaling, we can scale out in number of containers within a cluster. And the main also a resource efficiency, so it runs faster, right, start up faster, and have less size than compared to virtual machines. So as we have seen container runtime in our last slide, right, last to last slide in the diagram. So container runtime are responsible for setting up namespace and C groups, right? I have told you namespace are of two types, users namespace and kernel namespace. And we have C groups for limit the resource uses for containers. And then running commands inside those namespace and C groups are the task for container runtime. So as I told, we have a different type of container runtimes, like Docker container, Docker engine, right, Rocket, LXD, LXC, CRIO. So we have differentiated those into type of runtimes, like low level container runtime and high level container runtime. So low level container runtime just focus on running only containers, not managing those or managing different other features which provided by high level container runtime. So you can see in this below diagram, we have LXC, RunC, and LMCTFY. These are low level container runtimes, right? High level container runtimes support features like image management, image transport, image unpacking, sharing image, and gRPC, remote procedure call, and web APIs. So and both of these type of container runtimes are fundamentally different things that solve different problems. Means we can use low level container runtimes for our different use cases or different problems, and we can use our high level container runtime for different use cases. So out of this, CRIO, Containerd and RKT are the high level container runtimes. RKT is Rocket, Containerd is container runtime used by Docker or Docker engine, right? And CRIO is the third one, which is also a high level container runtime that you can will see in Kubernetes, right? So we can use any of these in Kubernetes. So we will see that in our future videos. So the main difference between this Containerd, which is used by Docker, and RKT is that Docker runs a central daemon, right? Because this is a central daemon which runs with root privileges and spins off a new container as its sub process, right? Whereas Rocket RKT, which is provided by from Core OS, okay, Core operating system, which is more secure because that never runs or spin a container with root privilege. It does not require root privileges. So to have those features in mind, we'll strongly recommend it to run our containers within SE Linux or AppArmor functionality, right? So this was all about container runtime, difference between bare metal, virtual machine and containers. So that's all for this lecture, and hope you would have understand all the terminologies which I discussed and all the these different virtualization technology, virtual machine or containerization, and also about that COVID concept. So thank you that for sharing and for watching, and stay safe, stay healthy, stay home. Thanks.